Hi, welcome students. We had been in the lesson ecosystem discussing regarding the energy flow and ecological pyramids in the ecosystem. Let us have a recapitulation of the previously discussed topic. Here in this page you find here the model of generalized energy flow in the ecosystem. Boxes represent the biotic components and the arrows show the pathway of energy transfer. GPP, you know, it is gross primary productivity, and A as assimilation. Here you see the downward arrows at each trophic level and in between also. Between these two trophic level, not utilized is the energy form. For example, the animal that we domesticate is provided food, that is animal fodder. The part of that fodder which is utilized by the domesticated animal or eaten by the domesticated animal forms the energy in the body of those animals, but some of the fraction of that fodder which the animal is not eating or it is wasted, that comes for the food material for the decomposers, and these food material provide energy to the decomposer. Similarly, herbivores and carnivores also, the part of the food that are not utilized by them is the part of the energy for the decomposers. So this model, the upward oblique arrow is showing the dissipation through respiration, dissipation of energy, the energy that is lost as the body heat from the organisms. So this energy flow in the ecosystem follows the 10% rule. The ecological pyramids, if we talk about pyramid of number in grassland, pyramid of number in terrestrial and pond ecosystem, these all pyramids are showing the upright fashion of the pyramid. Here you see the base is formed by the primary producer. In the terrestrial ecosystem, it is grass and plant. In pond ecosystem, it is phytoplankton. So these all are the producer in the ecosystem, and it forms the largest rectangle for the base. It shows that the number of the autotrophs in any ecosystem, be it the grassland or it is the terrestrial ecosystem, either forest or desert or somewhere else, it is the pond ecosystem, this autotroph is forming the base. The next higher trophic level is showing the smaller size, and the further the size of the rectangle is decreasing in size, it is representing the number. This number keep on decreasing as we move from lower trophic level to higher trophic level. Here you see the abnormal pyramid of number 1A, that is inverted, and B is spindle shaped. What we see, the tree is forming the base, which is the smallest rectangle, and as we move from tree to herbivore and thereafter to the parasite, we find that the size of the rectangle is increasing, and this is the inverted pyramid. This inverted pyramid is showing that the base, which is formed by the tree and it is the autotroph, its number is minimum, and as we go ahead in the higher trophic level, we find the number is increasing. So the pyramid of number in such a condition is increasing, but in the second pyramid you see here, the spindle shaped pyramid, what we say, the intermediate rectangle represented here is the trophic level of herbivorous birds, and the number of herbivorous bird is maximum. tree, if we talk a single tree, a lot of birds are coming to visit this tree and they are taking the food out of this tree. So the number of birds is much higher than that of the tree. And the top carnivore here is the hawk. This hawk is a fewer in number, so it is the spindle shaped pyramid. In the next pyramid, we are having a glance of the pyramid of biomass, and this biomass is also decreasing as we move from the lower trophic level to higher trophic level. The lower trophic level is representing the primary producer, thereafter the secondary primary consumer, thereafter the secondary consumer, and then the tertiary consumer. So the number and energy, we are talking of this energy in the higher trophic level keep on decreasing following the 10% rule. The 1000 kg of vegetation supports a biomass of only 100 kg of herbivore, which in turn shall form only 10 kg of biomass in the primary carnivore and only 1 kg in the secondary carnivore. Therefore, the cost of production of food from animal is much higher than the one obtained directly from the plant. A total dependence on animal diet will be disastrous. This is the conclusion. For example, the agricultural produce of Russia is at least twice of that of India, while its population is less than half of India. Pyramid of biomass is upright for terrestrial habitat. Inverted in spindle-shaped pyramids are obtained in aquatic habitat, whereas where the biomass of the trophic level depend upon the reproductive potential and longevity of its members. Thus, the biomass of phytoplankton may be smaller than that of the zooplankton, and that of the latter less than the primary carnivore. However, if total biomass produced per unit time is calculated, the pyramid of biomass shall always be upright. Well, that's all in this video. Thank you.